In this video, I'll show you how to use Desmos to do some simple calculations for our statistics class. So first thing is we need to go to the Desmos website, which is free. So go to your favorite browser, click desmos.com, and then big red button, start graphing. All right, so what we have here, over to the side, this is where we're going to put our formulas. Our graphs are going to show up here in the middle. And we need to launch a keyboard. So down here at the bottom, we're going to show the keyboard, and we're going to be using some of these functions here. So if I clicked on functions and then the stats menu, I'll see some things that I'll want to calculate, like the mean, statistics, quartiles, etc. So we'll get to that. So I've already started a spreadsheet which shows a lot of my examples, and I gave a link to this in the video that I will give to you. So what I have here is some examples ready to go. Well, how did I get data into Desmos? I went to my spreadsheet that had my data, and I'm going to select from all of these variables, just a few values to get a feel for how Desmos works. So I'm going to work with the variable keys. So I'm going to select a few numbers here and then copy it with a command or control C. So just copy and then go back to the Desmos tab. And when you start with Desmos, there's going to be like a blank here for your function. All you have to do is paste your data into that blank space. You can even start a new space down here or keep clicking and you can make more and more formulas. Just pick one, Velcro, control V, your data into space, and then it tells you how many elements are in your list, and it even puts some fancy brackets around your data set. And we need to give our data set now a letter. So I'm going to call this data set, let's see, I'm going to fix that. I'm going to call it data set A just for ease. You can call it L, you can call it B, any other value name. All right, so you might have noticed some changes down there because I hadn't edited my spreadsheet, but what happened up here, we've now named our data set, so now we can refer to our data whenever we want to do calculations or graphs. So let's say the first thing I want to do is make a dot plot. So I have my formula in there, but all you have to do is type dot plot and spell it correctly of A. And you'll notice that down below it says data set comma bin width. So that means that inside the parentheses, A is the data set we're using. And then the bin width is how wide we're going to make our bins. And by default, it's 1. If you want to make it 2 or 3, you can change that. Otherwise, it'll just stay 1. And then we'll push enter. Oh, didn't like that. Let's get rid of that. Dot plot. Where did our data go? Oh, this is actually a good learning moment. Where did our data go? I think it actually graphed, but we don't know that until we can actually see our data in this grid over here. So notice now there is a plus sign inside of that little magnifier and it says zoom fit. So if I click on that, my graph is going to zoom down to where my data is, wherever it was in the spreadsheet. If I want to change the look of this, because this is kind of overwhelming over here, I can click on the little wrench icon and change the graph settings. So I want to remove the grid. I don't like that. My x-axis, I think I should add a label. What was this? Number of keys. And then my y-axis, this could be count. Now this is a dot plot, so the y-axis is not totally necessary because we kind of assume that each little dot represents one person. Another change you may want to make is to change your x-axis and y-axis values if their axis is still too big for you. Maybe the y-axis, we only want it to go up to, let's say, 5. And our x-axis, maybe we want to cut that off at 10. It just trims down our graph a little bit so we can focus in on the data. All right, so that is a dot plot. Let's say I want to make a histogram. I type in the command histogram and then throw in the A for the data set. And easily enough, we get a histogram made right away. We can change the look of the histogram by using counts or relative frequency, so percentages. Don't forget to change your y-axis label. Density, same thing. Bin alignments, you can change that to be on the center of a digit if it's discrete numbers, or to the left, which makes more sense if you have continuous data and there can be fractional values. This would be a good opportunity to change your axis labels if you change your data set. All right, now there's two graphs right here on our page. If we only want to see one of them, we need to hide one of the graphs. So just click on the colored icon next to the function and then it'll disappear. And if you click again, it'll come back. So we can remove them so you can kind of save your graphs instead of losing all of your work. Now let's say I want to add in another graph. Let's do a box plot. Box plot of the A data. This offset, which we didn't see before, is kind of nice because it makes sure that your graphs are not stacked on top of each other so you can actually see them. So I'm going to turn off the dot plot and I'm going to zoom in on my box plot, which was nice. My offset is 10. It's a little high. Let's go back up to like 7 and see what happens. That's a little better. Let's change my y-axis. Let's start back down at, let's say, -1 and only go up to, I'm going to change it to 8 and then go back to make my offset to be 4. Here. That looks much nicer. I could even drop it down a little bit more if I wanted to. I could do count. There we go. So you can kind of match your histogram to your box plot, or maybe you want to match your dot plot to your box plot. And then you can see the density of exactly how many points are where, and then why the quartiles are the way they are. So you notice that there's a big span here between Q1 and Q3, and that's because there's very little data spread between about 3 and 7. And then when there's more data, then you get the quartiles closer to one another, so there's more dense data. All right, let's move on to statistics. Now, you notice that I zoomed in and out there. I just used my touchpad and scroll, not scroll up and down, but you can zoom up and down, in and out with your fingers. All right, so you want to get rid of some of the spaces. You can click on X, deletes the space. All right, let's do some statistics. We can go to the little keyboard that pops up here, click on functions, and if you want to just select from the list, you can choose stats, and then automatically the word stats comes up, and then you can put in your data set. So that's what I did right here. You can also just remember stats of data set A, and then when you push enter, boom, you get your 5-number summary spit out just like that. If you want to find the mean of your data set, just only the mean, type in, you start with a blank space, mean, parenthesis, A, close, and then the answer will show up right down below in that gray box. If you want to do quartiles, that works a little bit differently. You need to tell it the data set, but you need to tell it which quartile to work with. So I'm going to choose the third quartile. So I put in 3 for the third quartile, and you notice that the answer is 7, which does match up with Q3 back up here in this stats panel. The median for data set A is 3. That matches up there. Of course, you will get the same answers, but it just is proof that you can do things singly, or you can get it all in one fell swoop and get the same answers. Standard deviation of the data set. Just type in STDEV of A and you'll get the sample standard deviation. If you want to do the population standard deviation, go back to your functions and then notice that there's STDEVP, P for population. Bring that up. So if your data happens to represent a population, then this is the more correct calculation for that data set. All right, some of the functions that you will end up using mean, median, min, max, quartile. Quantile is generic, so it could be like the 53rd percentile instead of just the 25, 75, and 50 that we're used to using. Standard deviation again, that's mean absolute deviation, variance, population variance, correlation, we'll see that later, and then your statistics, we can do some of these other tests later on. Under the, let's see, where was it? Stats. Ah, and under DIST, you can find those visualizations. So here's the button to click histogram, so you don't have to remember that word, dot plot, box plot. And then we'll use some of these other distributions later on in a couple weeks. But for right now, you have a number of graphs of your data and how to calculate statistics pretty easily using Desmos.